with the air sealing, our thermal insulation put into place, our vapor barrier put into place correctly, and our moisture barrier, we're gonna have a durable building.
In kind of keeping with today's conversation, we've been talking about the building envelope. And we're getting into some of the specifics. One of the things that in the market, there's a lot of different vapor barriers and air barriers, and obviously with your experience in the different types of construction, this is something you pretty much deal with regularly.
That's correct. What we've seen is a transition of materials with technology improving and things like that. We're seeing the products that are available to us both in number and sort of the technology of those products. We have to make sure that we're current with everything that's out there and how those interact with other products in the building. Tar paper used to be a way of keeping air out and controlling moisture and things like that. That's a product that comes in 3-foot rolls. So every 3 foot in your building, you've got a seam that you need to deal with, either lapping that in the right direction or dealing with that. Then they came out with building wrap products that you see very often. Those became bigger sheets and had less of these laps and conditions that you had to deal with. So that was a good thing. And now we see the technology moving into peel and stick products that stick themselves onto the building, that you don't have to put fasteners through it, holes in your system basically. And even to seamless products now, where it's either a spray applied or a roll applied product where you have no seams, so it's a continuous barrier. So as the technology changes, we get to make that performance improve in a lot of ways. And then the other component of that is these products can either be vapor permeable, which allows vapor to move in and out of it, which is a desirable thing in certain conditions, or vapor non-permeable, where it is a barrier that keeps vapor from traveling from one side of it to the other. And where you locate those in the wall is very important. We live in a climate in Chicago here that we live in primarily a warming condition. We're heating our building more than we're cooling it. So our vapor barriers and air barriers want to be placed in the wall at the proper location relative to insulation. So in our environment, we typically want that control layer to be on the warm side of our insulation. In the southern climate, where you're in the cooling conditions most of the year, it's the exact opposite. You want that control layer on the outside of your insulation. So again, you need to understand where you're building and where would be the appropriate place to put some of these layers in the building.
And I assume the type of construction also has the impact, what the exterior of the building would be, as well as the functional.
That's correct. Depending on what your exterior cladding might be, you might be using one, either a permeable or a non-permeable membrane might be desirable. And those are types of things that we look at when we're reviewing the documents and making recommendations for products.